12 forecast.
All right, if you do not like humidity, I think you're going to like this weather forecast that I deliver for the next 3 minutes or so. So let's get right to it, our three key things. I do want to let you know about some showers overnight, a slight chance of a thunderstorm or a downpour. I think for the most part, it's plain old rain showers. There may be some stronger thunderstorms lurking just offshore, so we'll keep a close eye on that overnight. A slow start Friday. What I mean is that we'll start with some showers, some clouds, and then gradually brighten up the skies throughout the day. Humidity will be on leave starting tomorrow all the way through early next week. Here are the high temperatures from today. We made it to 90 in Providence, 86 in Smithfield, 91 in Taunton. With that humidity, it certainly felt even warmer than that. Very sticky out there today, and that's because we're ahead of a cold front. As long as we're east of this front, we hang on to that soupy air mass. But guess what? We get behind that front. We get on the more comfortable side of this front as we head into Friday. The front slowly slides through overnight into tomorrow morning and may take a few showers along with it. So let's walk you through that part of the forecast. This is around 2 o'clock in the morning. Now, if you don't like rain, good news is a lot of this will be falling while you sleep. It may actually be pretty good news for the lawns and gardens out there. Now, early tomorrow morning, I think any downpours or potential thunderstorms which are around, and I think those will be few and far between, but if they do materialize, they should be out of here for the Friday morning commute. So this is around 6, 7 a.m. I think we're mostly done with the downpours, but some showers still around. By noontime, notice what happens. The showers start to pull down to the south, perhaps some lingering cloud cover, and then by Friday afternoon, we start to bring in the brighter skies. So again, it's just a day of patience for Friday, especially if you're heading down to the beach. Overnight temperatures falling through the 70s with some showers, downpours, and a slight chance of a thunderstorm. And then tomorrow morning, we start things out in the upper 60s at around 7 a.m. with some showers. Noontime, maybe a lingering shower or two along the coast, but I think we're mostly done with the showers at this point. Temperature around 74 with the mostly cloudy skies. And then by 3 o'clock in the afternoon, upper 70s, a nice breeze out of the northwest at around 5 to 10 miles an hour. And that breeze will feel nice. Again, if you don't like that humidity, that's a pretty comfortable wind direction around here. So across the board tomorrow, upper 70s, this is around 1 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon. We're talking upper 70s from Smithfield, Providence, and down into Newport, Jamestown, and Wesley. So not a bad late afternoon, perhaps at the beach. Not a bad afternoon maybe to hit the golf course. Certainly not too warm. And at the beach, some morning clouds, maybe some fog as well with some showers, and then brighter skies into the afternoon. High temperatures into the mid 70s. All right, let's talk dew points. I can't remember the last time I had a dew point forecast this consistent. We keep you in the refreshing category all the way through the weekend, and it does actually get pretty cool as we head into Sunday, so you will be able to give your air conditioner a break this weekend. Notice in the 7-day forecast, the warmer of the 2 days, and Saturday's not that warm, it's pretty comfortable. 78 mostly sunny for Saturday. That would be my pick of the weekend. Sunday is a little cooler and a little cloudier, maybe a little bit of drizzle or miss late in the day on Sunday. Monday is cool and cloudy, low 70s, and then we gradually start to warm things up Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday with the chance of some showers approaching by the middle of next week. But definitely a big old change up in our weather pattern on the way for the next several days.
Not going to really feel like summer, is it?
Not for a few days.
No. Nope. All right. Thank you, Pete. Coming up next on Eyewitness News at 10, details on how